Here we are camping, first time in 2 years. Yes, so this is the minivan that brought us here. We're at 50 Point Conservation Area, a place I've been coming to my entire life, but first time I've ever been camping here. It's close to home. We're only gonna be here for 3 days, and I thought I'd show you around. So here's our trailer that we got a bunch of years back now. It's a Starcraft, it's 2005. It's got a queen on one side and a double on the other side. We've done some modifications inside, and I might do a video about that later. But I'm gonna show you around the campsite. This is my charging area. Sandy gave me a solar cell years ago, and just for trying to get it working. So there's the Canadian Tire charge controller, but basically it's not going to battery, it's going to a USB. So right now it's probably charging that battery. I was charging this GoPro for a bit, but and we got a lawn chair set up for later when the sun goes down. Those little patio lanterns are solar, the solar cells on top. So when the sun goes down, they'll light up. We just picked up this carpet yesterday. It's an 8x10. We're so happy about it. Our old carpet's over there, but this is utterly fantastic. This is really nice. So this is one of our additions that we did on our trailer when we first got it, since we put these shelves on that are removable, Home Depot Super Specials, wire mesh shelves. The other thing we did is we, again, we're not gonna go inside right now, but when we go inside, I'll show you that we removed the sink. So we came up with this. Again, this is the plastic shelving you get at Home Depot or just Canadian Tire or whatever. And we cut a hole in one of the shelves and put a sink in it. It works quite well. And one of the other things, so we got our little stove for cooking, and we got our barbecue all fed off this tree here, and a little lantern on top for when it gets dark. It connects to one propane cylinder. Again, Sandy got us this barbecue a bunch of years back. It's fantastic. This is my other new favorite. Well, not new, I've had it for a bunch of years now. To bring water into the campsite. So basically, you just go over to Canadian Tire and you buy yourself a fork, pitchfork, and you drill a hole through it like that, and then you just weld on a faucet, an exterior faucet, and then more copper, and then it connects to this garden hose, which is joined there, and then this regular garden hose goes all the way back over here to the water connection. So you can actually, instead of coming over here all the time, you can bring the water right into the campsite. So that's what I like doing. So it's also handy, and of course you can see, yeah, we have power hook up too, which is, you know, nice too. But I'm trying to get to the point where we can work solely on solar cells, so we can go way out in the wilderness at some point. But so that's my nice little thing. I actually built that at camping once. I brought my acetylene torch, my butane torch, and soldered it up around the campfire one night. And Sandy was wondering what I was doing, and I brought all the parts with me. So I went over to Home Depot, and again, I bought two elbows, just a length of copper, the hose bib, and then I had the connection there. So it works out well. So you can just use it right in here. I also put like a shoe mat underneath so it doesn't wreck the dirt underneath and makes it all muddy. So that's it for now, until we get inside. But again, those are our mods to this trailer, is the shelving on the outside, which comes in so handy. Our dishwashing station, our cooking station. That's a folding table that folds right down and goes inside the trailer. And yeah, so there she be. That's all our, that's all ours. I got a few more ideas for, oh, this is something I just added yesterday while we're here, before you say goodbye. Drying towels. So there's not too many places for a clothesline around here. So I put these little loops underneath and these broom handles, and you can put your towels on top of that, or your wet clothes or whatever, and they can just sit out there and dry underneath the trailer. Also, everything's tucked underneath the trailer there to keep it nice and cool out of the sun. So there you go.
Hey, I have these
all good. Talk to you guys later. Take care. Bye. Okay, well, we'll take a closer look at the trailer. So as I said previously, this was one of the first things we did. We went over to Canadian, Home Depot. We bought the uprights and then the shelving thing. So these come off. The nice wire mesh shelves. Two of them. I mean, you can add three, but we went with two for now. And we try to make it the same height here for this. The easy use, and that's our quote-unquote pantry. Well, pantry, our dish cupboard. I might build something out of wood at some point. Plates and stuff, they all fit in there. This is like all our cling wraps and all that stuff, garbage bags and tea towels and stuff. So this is going to get better in the future, but it's worked for now. Stuff on the ground is like ropes for whatever. It's not like a box. It's full of ropes and pegs and stuff like that. Our bocce ball, or that little bin way at the bottom there, is it's a tote full of our pipes and stuff, and extra filaments for the lanterns. So that holds the tree and stuff. Charcoal for our hibachi, which we might be using later. So this works out well. This works out well. Dish rack. The toaster's not usually here, but I made Sandy and myself a sandwich earlier. So this is where we do our dishes when we're camping. And again, that's just one of those shelving kits that you get at Canadian Tire or Home Depot. And then I just cut a hole in this one. Yeah, that's pretty useful. I think I used my jigsaw. Some people put a drain in. We don't. So, and a drying rack, and the stove and the barbecue setup. So let's go inside. Usually the zero G is not here. It's out there, but it's just bright and sunny out. There's not a lot of shade on this site. So, Sandy was using it here. So, let's go inside and talk about the mods we've done inside. We just picked up this little piece of carpet yesterday. I am going to glue it to the step because it's nicer than the steel. Pretty much the same as when we bought it, except a few changes. We got rid of the sink that was in here. There used to be a sink right here and a stovetop here. I removed all that. I removed all the propane except for the heater, which is hidden behind here. We won't be using it. The heater still works, but I removed the stove and I removed the sink. The owners before us had a little bit of water damage, and you can just maybe see it here. This is like all, you know, it's particle board that's covered by, covering, melamine or whatever. Sandy and I just put this on yesterday because it used to be that color wood, and we're trying to see if we can spruce it up. So we took out the sink, we took out the stove, put a new top on. So right now this is just a glorified shelf for stuff. Future state is I'm going to, on the front, I'm going to put these guys in here. These plastic shelves I'm going to put over here. And we're gonna free up this space here, and maybe all this space here. So this is what we did in our old trailer, and we did it in this trailer here. This used to be a storage unit that was built into the trailer. It had a little door there, and a little door there, and a little door here, and it was very hard, like little tiny 1 foot doors to get in that huge space. And of course the wheel wells underneath there too. And the gas that would go to the stove that used to be connected to the outside if you wanted that, and we just removed all that. So I ripped out the entire storage area, except I saved the counter, the top, and I built, knotty pine. And then we bought these things at Home Depot or Canadian Tire or wherever. And it's so much easier than those stupid little doors trying to get access to stuff. So before, this would be, when we go camping, we would take all the storage stuff in there, like the lanterns and stuff, and we'd put our clothes in there. But lately, this is what we're doing. We're getting these things hanging from the ceiling. So again, I think this is Dollar Store Super Special or somewhere. Sandy got them. Over here is ours. And of course, all their clothes are in there. So we don't actually have to put our clothes in there anymore. You can actually see mine's labeled and Sandy's is labeled. Josh's used to be labeled. So we're doing this now because then we can free up the space. And what we're talking about now is, we're going to remove this entire thing. We're going to put a new floor in first of all. We're going to remove this entire thing, make it like a little couch with maybe a shelf underneath because again, we have our board games in there, Catan, obviously, and some, you know, kettles and stuff. So we don't want to lose all the storage here, but we don't mind losing the clothing, because the clothing are going up here. Our next big thing is we're actually, because this is the 12 120 and propane fridge, which doesn't do what we want it to do. I mean, it works. We're going to remove all this. We're going to take all this out, and we're going to put a just 120 volt, because we're not off the grid usually when we're camping. We're going to put a 120 volt fridge. It's a regular small bar fridge in there. The smallest one we can find. We're going to probably leave the heater, because we actually like camping in the late fall, and that heater is great. Except, where is it? Where did I hide them? Oh, right here. We found these. These are, there's no moving parts. These are electric heaters. Again, we're not going to be off the grid. You know, there's plugs here and there's plugs all over this thing. So that's going to be perfect. We don't need to use the built-in propane heater. There was also a little step here that was just crap. So we are actually, we removed it. And we're going to put a real nice step that's storage. I saw a video once, and it's probably going to come out to here, and then you'll be able to step on it. And oh, Josh hops up there anyway, but that's additional storage. But right now it's not there. We're going to wait till we put the floor in. This is original, except again, I put a shelf in. The shelf's not standard. This was just a wide open thing. So the shelf just helps with storage. So at the bottom, we'll come in this side. I put extra extension cords, extra rope, my hatchet, my level when I'm leveling this thing. This is what I use. We had one that was stuck to the wall here, a little tiny one the guy put in. It was really neat, but I said, no, just look at it. Here's the level. So I leave that level in here. Didn't need it this time, because this campsite actually has the 30 amp plug outside, but we have the 30 to regular plug converter. And again, the shoe boxes that we use to store Lego at home also work fantastically in here. So we got six shoe boxes in here. That's all our mosquito repellent stuff. This is our bungees, then our tool kits there, and our batteries and lights and stuff like that. And then back more stuff for when we're camping. This is our hammock. We bought a hammock at a campsite years ago. They had a camp sale and somebody had a hammock on for like a couple bucks. The problem is I can't use it here. There's no trees to connect it to. So this is original, and this is probably gonna stay. When we put the new floor in, I might rip all this stuff out. I don't know yet. One other major thing, because of the water damage over there, I removed all the water stuff. So before, this thing had a tank right there, and I took it out. So now the storage is where I actually store all my barbecues. Well, I don't put the barbecue, but the stoves and all the propane stuff, all the pipes that I showed you the tote outside. And I put this little wall here to separate this, where all my stove stuff is, from the actual electrical cord storage. So there's the electrical cord storage. Again, this thing's removed. See, this is the old water drainage. Gone, don't care. So I put this thing here, and I put on this side, because again, this used to be a water reservoir, a water tank. And so you didn't need this. So this is separating this storage from the electrical system, which I am going to overhaul. Because it works on 120, so again, right now we're plugged in, everything comes on, and I will show you. I replaced all the LED, all the regular incandescent 12 volt bulbs with the LEDs, which is fantastic. But this trailer will not work off of 12 volts right now, and I think, as we found out earlier, it's because I had to redo all the electrical for the tail lights right before this trip. Because the taillights weren't working properly from the front. The ground wires are rusted through. So I'm actually gonna run from the battery, and I might go outside and show you, but maybe not. I'm gonna run a ground from the battery terminal straight to here at some point. I think I need 10 AWG. I'm gonna talk to the experts, but so that's the next overall. So if we do choose to go off grid, if you wanna do what they call boondocking, finding out all these new words that I didn't know before, we will, because as I said, we got the solar cells. We got the inverters, the chargers, blah blah blah, the monitors. So I don't mind going off grid at some point, but I have to make sure the 12 volts working, and right now it's not. If we unplug from power, this whole trailer turns off. If we unplug from the 120, even though the battery's perfectly fine, and I traced the power to the ground wire, and it doesn't go past the ground wire. So that's my next, I got a few things to do. We're gonna put the new fridge in. We're gonna probably put a nice day couch there with storage underneath. We're gonna put a new floor in for sure. I mean, it's only 15 years old, this trailer, and it's just beautiful. The people who did own it, besides this small water damage, they took extremely good care of it. It was, when we bought it off them a bunch of years back, it was mint, except for the water damage. And they cleaned it. It was beautifully used. They stored it nicely. There was no mold. It was just a beautiful trailer, and it's like one of the best trailers I've ever been in. And yet, the trailer that we had before that Uncle Ted gave us, we loved modifying that. the trailer was mint, but the very first thing I did was rip that out because I couldn't handle, like, there was a little door here, little vertical door, and there's a little door here. If you looked up a 2005 StarCraft template pop-up, and there's a little door there, like three little doors, and that was it. And then you had to like scooch in everywhere else to get access to whatever you're trying to get access to. And even when I was trying to put my my marshmallow roasting sticks in there, they were like, let's just screw it. So I could have, and I was actually just thinking about this week, I could have, because this is a 1x8 here, or 1x6 here, that I cut down. So the hub of the wheel comes right up to here. So this is actually wasted space here, and that's wasted space over there. I could have put little hatches. I mean, I can't, you know, use all the space, but this little triangle here, waste of space. This is a void behind here. So if we do get rid of here, the couch will go to here maybe, and then we might put the toilet right here inside the trailer. I don't know yet. To be determined. And yeah, so this is a void too, inside here. Complete void, but I do have access from underneath here, and this is actually, I use that for storage when we pack up the trailer. That's where I put the garden hose, which you saw outside, that connects to my pitchfork. So our winter project is to sew up all brand new curtains and a new valance all the way around, because again, these are very nice. We washed them, they were beautiful when we got them, but it looks dated, so we saw some nice videos online, and we're going to get some material from wherever, and we're going to sew up brand new valances and curtains, and I guess that'll be my job on my mom's old sewing machine. I'm looking forward to that. A few other things that we want to do is get better lighting in here, because, you know, this is it. Like when you're in bed and the curtains are closed and Sandy wants to read, there's, you know, she brings this thing from the dollar store. You know, it's not bad, but I wouldn't mind something that hangs down or up here in the corner or something. I don't know yet. We're going to get some ideas. There's so many people online with great ideas for these kind of pop-up trailers, and well, you can modify them. But what I want to do is, when I modify them, I don't want it to look like crap. And I do regret I didn't save the fascia from the old piece to cover this. This looks like crap to me, so I want to fix that with the couch. Like, I don't mind that piece of wood along the bottom. I mean, we should stain it, or it's, so it looks like this. Or if we do to something. Oh, this is the water pump switch, which isn't connected to anything right now, obviously, because I took the water pump and the tank out. But anyway, I think I've talked enough about this. Hope you liked it. This is our trailer. This is what we want to use for camping for a long, long time. We love camping, and it's our first time in 2 years, unfortunately, because of life that happened. But we are going to go do a lot more camping, possibly more in the fall. So I want everybody to stay safe out there. And I will talk to you all soon. Take care.